Is your Pixel 8 dying way too fast? Don't rush out and buy a new phone just yet. In this video, I'll show you how to replace your battery step by step, and by the end, your phone will be running like new. Before we get started, let's make sure you have everything you need for this repair. You'll need an eye opener, a hairdryer or heat gun, a suction handle or anti-clamp, some iFixit opening picks, a spudger, isopropyl alcohol, a T3 Torx driver, and a microfiber cloth. You'll also need your replacement battery, some new display adhesive, a fresh graphite sheet, a Pixel 8 shim, and a new thermal pad. And like always, we recommend having a fix mat around to help keep you organized during your repair. When it's time to do your repair, make sure to follow the step-by-step guide on iFixit.com, as you can see all the latest changes to the repair process, if any, and read helpful hints from other people who've done the repair. Before you begin, let your Pixel's battery drain to below 25%, as a charged lithium-ion battery can catch fire if it's damaged. So, safety first. Unplug all cables and power off your phone completely. To do this, press the power and volume up buttons at the same time to bring up the shutdown menu. All right, now we're going to separate the screen from the frame using opening picks. Be careful here. If you insert them too far, you can damage your device. To prevent this, measure 3 millimeters from the tip of your pick and mark it with a permanent marker. Heat an eye opener and lay it along the bottom edge of the screen for about 2 minutes. If you don't have an eye opener, a hairdryer or heat gun or even a hot plate will work, but be careful not to overheat the screen or battery. If you're using an anti-clamp, this is where it really comes in handy. Unlock the arms by pulling the blue handle back, place your phone screen side up on an object to keep it level, and position the suction cups near the bottom edge. Squeeze the cups together to create suction, then pull the handle forward to lock the arms. Turn the handle clockwise one full turn until the suction cups start to stretch. Then wait about a minute for a gap to form. If the screen doesn't separate, turn the handle a bit more and apply additional heat. If you're not using the anti-clamp, apply a suction handle to the center of the screen's bottom edge and pull up with steady force until a gap appears. If it's stubborn, apply more heat and try again. Once you have a gap, carefully insert an opening pick, but don't go deeper than 3 millimeters to avoid damaging the internal components. Now we're going to work our way around the phone. Slide the opening pick along the bottom edge to separate the adhesive and leave it in the bottom right corner to keep the screen from resealing. Apply heat to the right edge for 2 minutes, then insert another pick and slide it to the top right corner, leaving it in place. Repeat this process for the top, then left edges, always applying heat first and making sure not to insert the pick too far. Once the screen is free, carefully swing it open like a book from the right side. Just be gentle as the screen cable is still attached. If you feel resistance, go around with the opening pick again to loosen any remaining adhesive. Prop up the screen so you can access the cable connection, and then use an opening pick to pry up the upper edge of the screen cable cover and remove it. Then use the point of a spudger to gently disconnect the screen's press connector. At this point, the screen is completely free. Your Pixel 8 may come with a 5G millimeter wave antenna. If your phone has one, make sure to follow the steps on our site to disconnect it. We need to remove the large graphite sheet. This sheet connects the upper part of the battery, the midframe, and the rear cameras. Use a spudger to lift the top right corner and then carefully peel it away. If it tears, just remove it in sections. Remember, you'll need a new graphite sheet when reassembling. There's also a plastic buffer lightly adhered to the midframe and bottom speaker. Use an opening pick to loosen it and then grab it with tweezers or your fingers and peel it off. Now, remove the two screws securing the USB-C port bracket using a T3 Torx driver, and then take out the bracket. Let's take out the midframe next. Remove the 8 screws securing it, and then use a spudger to gently separate it from the thermal pad. Once it's loose, lift it off and set it aside. If the thermal pad looks damaged, clean the area with isopropyl alcohol and replace it with a new one. Now we're ready to remove the battery. First, disconnect the battery connector with a spudger. The battery is held down with strong adhesive, so flip your phone over and use your heat gun or hairdryer to heat the back cover near the top and bottom edges. Once it's warm, flip the phone back over and apply a few drops of isopropyl alcohol along the right edge of the battery, and then tilt the phone so that the alcohol gets underneath the battery. Let it sit for a minute, and then try and use the attached pull tabs to separate the adhesive. Using a sawing motion, pull the strip up towards the top of the battery, and then work your way down to the bottom. If you have issues with the included pull tab, try using an opening pick to gently pry up the battery. Be patient, as this can take a few rounds of heat and alcohol. Whatever you do, don't bend or crease the battery. Once the battery is free, clean up any remaining adhesive with isopropyl alcohol and a lint-free cloth. If your new battery has pre-installed adhesive, just remove the plastic liner. If not, apply double-sided tape to where the old adhesive was. Hold the new battery above its recess, reconnect the battery connector, and then firmly place the battery into place. Reinstall the midframe and secure it with 8 T3 Torx screws. Place the USB-C bracket in place, securing it with its 2 screws. Then reapply a new plastic shim and press it into place. Finally, align and adhere new graphite tape. If your new screen comes with pre-installed adhesive, now's the time to get it ready. Peel off all the liners, including the perimeter adhesive, and then reconnect the screen's cable and reinstall its cover. When reconnecting your display, be sure to align the press connector over its socket and press down on one side first and then the other. Avoid pressing in the middle. Misalignment can damage the pins permanently. Before sealing it up, power on your phone to make sure everything's working as expected. If it all looks good, power it down and press the screen firmly into place. You should feel the clip snap in. Press around the perimeter to secure the adhesive, and if you want an even stronger bond, apply some pressure across the phone. Head on over to iFixit.com to check out our page on how to calibrate your new battery, what the process does, and why it's good to do. And that's it! You've successfully replaced your Pixel 8 battery.